Burayr ibn Khudhayr al-Hamdani al-Mishraqi was from the household of Banu Mishraq, from the Hamdan tribe, residing in the holy city of Kufa. He was known for his expertise in the field of the Holy Quran. He was a great exegete and reciter of the Holy Quran. Burayr taught the Holy Quran in the Holy Mosque of Kufa. In fact, Sunni scholars such as At-Tabari and Ibn Athir regard Burayr as Sayyid al-Qurra, the head or the leader of the reciters of the Holy Quran. Again, you find Ibn Babawai and Al-Fattal and Nishafuri referred to Burayr as the best of all reciters in his time. Burayr, upon hearing about the departure of Aba Abdullah al-Hussein from the holy city of Medina, he quickly rushed and joined the caravan in the holy city of Makkah. And since then, he remained with Aba Abdullah until he responded to the calling of his maker on the 10th day of Muharram. On the eve of Ashura, my dear brothers and sisters, as you know very well, our beloved Imam Hussein gathered his companions and addressed them. He permitted them to go and he said to them, "You are free as I am the target and none of you is the target. And whoever goes, there will be no sin on him." Companions, all of them responded positively to the calling of Aba Abdullah in such a way that they declared their obedience and readiness to defend their beloved master and the Imam of their time. On that night, which is the eve of Ashura, Burayr requested humbly from Aba Abdullah al-Hussein to permit him to go and dialogue and talk to Umar ibn Sa'd. Permission was granted by Aba Abdullah. Burayr headed to the camp of Umar ibn Sa'd. He met him and he challenged him not to wage war and fight Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. Umar ibn Sa'd did not take heed to the challenge posed to him by Burayr. Burayr returned back to the camp and he reported the dialogue he had with Umar ibn Sa'd to Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. On the day of Ashura, Burayr, like any other companion of Imam al-Hussein, demonstrated practically their wilaya or love for Ahlul Bayt and Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He first joked with Abdul Rahman, the son of Abdullah al-Ansari. Abdul Rahman looked at Burayr and he said to Burayr, "This is not a moment for joke. It's a moment of seriousness." Burayr then looked at Abdul Rahman and responded to him humbly. He said, "Oh my brother, my family knows that I was not humorist when I was young, let alone now that I am old. But I'm aware of what we will soon meet. I swear to God that the only distance between us and the pleasure of Almighty Allah is the attack by these people on us with their swords. I would like it to happen now." This was the response of Burayr to Abdul Rahman. And we gather from this response his readiness to defend the cause of Allah and to defend Aba Abdullah al-Hussein alayhi salam. And there's one unique thing about Burayr, which is He was never hesitant to respond to the challenge of the enemies. On the 10th day of Muharram, Salim and Yasser, who were the servants of Ziyad ibn Abi and Ubaidullah ibn Ziyad, challenged Burayr to come and fight them. Burayr made an attempt to respond to their challenge. Rabah Abdullah ibn Hussein alayhi salam said to Burayr, "No, your time is not yet." Instead, Imam al-Hussein permitted Abdullah ibn Umar to go and respond to their challenge. Abdullah ibn Umar went to the front and he began to respond to their challenge. They looked at Abdullah ibn Umar and they said to him, "We do not know you. We know Habib, Zuhair ibn al-Qayn, and Burayr." This demonstrates to us that no doubt Burayr was a great warrior and a true lover and follower of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. Again, on the 10th day of Muharram, Burayr had the opportunity, and this opportunity was presented and permitted by Abu Abdullah to address the enemy and to invite them to go back to their senses and to reflect on what they were about to do. But unfortunately, the enemies did not take that lesson on board. Finally, on the 10th day of Muharram, a man from the camp of the enemies by the name Yazid ibn Makke disputed and shouted at Burayr. Then Burayr looked at him and challenged him to come for Mubahala. The man responded to the challenge posed by Burayr. Burayr looked at the sky and he prayed that may Allah have the liar between the two of them killed. They went on one to one and eventually the man got caught. On this day and night, we remember his great warrior and companion of Abu Abdullah Hussein alayhi salam. And we pledge the Imam of our time to follow and emulate his footsteps. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.